News 18's exclusive news break. We've got some information from our top government sources about Pakistan's allegations against Indians that Indians are involved in killings on Pakistani soil. Sources have said that DGISPR claims that are extremely false and fabricated against Indians. In fact, the top intelligence sources have told us that we need evidence to show that Indian involvement is in fact there in any of the targeted killings on the soil of Pakistan, and Pakistan allegations about ceasefire violations are completely baseless, and Indian side was only protecting borders at the time when Pakistan was busy to infiltrate terrorists on our soil. Let's listen into what Pakistan DGISPR has to say.
Bharat ki janib se hame mashriqi sarhad par lagatar khatrat hain. Bharat hamesha ki tarah अपने अंदरूनी इंतशार से तवज्जो हटाने के लिए जो मनसूबाबंदी कर रहा है, पाकिस्तान की आला सिविल और अस्करी क्यादत उससे बाखूबी आगाह है। रवां साल में अब तक मुतअद्दिद मरतबा भारत की जानिब से छोटी सतह पर मुख्तलिफ सीज फायर की खिलाफवर्जियां की गईं, जिसमें स्पेकुलेटिव फायर के 120, एयर स्पेस वायलेशंस के 15 जबकि टेक्निकल एयर वायलेशंस के 59 वाकयात शामिल हैं। भारतीय फौज आजाद जम्मू और कश्मीर में लाइन ऑफ कंट्रोल पर मासूम और नहते शहरियों को निशाना बना रही है।
We have CNN News 18's Abhishek Jha joining us on the phone line to bring us more updates about the word coming in from DGISPR of Pakistan. Abhishek, a very good morning to you. Please first take us back to the allegations that Pakistan actually made back in January also. They said that there are targeted killings happening in Canada and in Pakistan also, and Indians are involved in it.
Well, there are two major issues that DGISPR is trying to blame it on India. First is, of course, the ceasefire violation that he's trying to say. We have seen the persistent terrorists infiltrating through the borders along Pakistan has been a menace, has been a concern for India. We have seen how security forces have been regularly engaged with terrorists, and several of them have been neutralized. Also, even in recent days, there have been attacks on army and air force convoys there. So the situation is largely responsibly coming from the Pakistani side, which is terrorists. Cross-border terrorism, which Pakistan needs to address, and blaming it on India that they are trying to do a ceasefire violation. That is largely because India doesn't want these terrorists to infiltrate, and they want them to be neutralized at the border itself. Talking about the issue of Indians involved in killing of Hardeep Singh Nijjar, of course there have been multiple documented evidences that how Pakistan, its spy agency ISI, has been behind fomenting this anti-India and pro-Khalistani sentiment across the world. There have been multiple officials of Pakistani government who have been meeting these senior leaders of so-called pro-Khalistani movement across the world, in Canada, in UK, in Australia. And Pakistan cannot wash its hands off from all the issues. And mostly the gangster violence and the criminals who have been behind these multiple attacks and law and order situation in Canada, they could be behind the killing of Hardeep Singh Nijjar, and pinning the blame on India is something that the Pakistan should avoid.
Right, Abhishek. Thank you so much for bringing us all those crucial updates on that story. We'll keep coming back to you for more updates. Right now, shifting focus to another piece of breaking news now coming in from the state of Haryana.